That is a sympathetic story. How could they be so wicked?
My princess, the evil that men do will always live with them. These men were paid in their own coin.
But why is it that the community were afraid of them? The chief priest and even the king.
Oh, my princess. That was the same question I asked my daddy when he first told me the story.
But we shall soon find out if everybody was afraid of them. You see?
These two evil rainmakers had committed so many atrocities until one day they touched the tiger's tail. You know, something more deadly happened. Something more deadly than they ever expected happened.
Great one, we appreciate your healing power. We thank you for making us well again. Thank you. Thank you, great one.
You must be very careful.
We will. Yes, yes. Be very careful this time around. Must be careful. We must find out who sent that thunder to come and kill us.
Yes, sure.
And the moment we find out who the person is, he or she must face our wrath.
Yes, yes.
We must kill the person.
Yeah.
Hey! Let us go.
Mazie Lendo, you and your wife accuse my humble self. And the cheer. Who do you people are saying? We were behind your daughter's madness and blindness. And I ask you before the Igwe and the elders, did you see us committing the crime?
That's the question. We didn't see you. But from all indication, we are quite sure you did it.
Indication of what?
Igwe, we must take an oath because we cannot allow this insult and this accusation from Mazi Elendo and his wife to just go like that.
Mazi Udene, I think you're correct. The oath taking is the only solution to this problem. Mm-hmm.
And in furtherance to that, Igwe, if at the end of the oath taking, and it was proven that both of us were innocent, they will not go unpunished. They will not go unpunished. And agreed? Do we all agree?
Agree, yes.
In addition to that, Mazelen, I will advise you to go home and think. Think before any oath is taken.
Igwe, there is no problem. Let's take the oath first.
Right. Okay. It's all right.
Okay. Now that we are all in agreement about the oath taking, come tomorrow morning, all of you will go to Ugugu Shrine and take the oath. Be it known, anyone found guilty will pay dearly for it.
Yes.
Well, thank you, Igwe.
it is wise for both of us to leave village at the same time. You will have to stay behind and take care of the situation. Let me go to Arochukwu and sell this head of Ogugu so that we can make our cowries. And you continue to have so many wives.
It is good. But make sure you come back on time.
I will.
You remember tomorrow we are going to take an oath.
Oh, yes. That is, if there will be any oath taken. But I'll return. I'll come back.
Nsiko.
I'm going to return with bags of curry. Trust me.
No.
Cowries. The head of Ogugu. Cowries. White man. Arotugu. Here I come. After this, I'll reside where there is a more we've included. If we will ever make money. Hey! Arab Nagungume! Your Highness,
there is fire on the mountain. Our community is doomed.
What is it, Ezemo? What happened?
Ogugu is missing. They have stolen the head of Ogugu.
What?
They have stolen the head of Ogugu.
Who must have taken away Ogugu from its place? Who?
I am confused. I went to the bush to collect some herbs. On returning, only to discover that Ogugu is no more.
This is sacrilege. This is sacrilege. What do we do? Who must have removed Ogugu?
Don't know because of our forefathers.
This is terrible. The Ogugu said that has been here for a long time. Just to miss like that.
For the first time in history.
Oh,
first time in this community.
Igwe, there's danger. If we don't find it in 7 Ekemake days, I'm afraid there will be trouble in this land.
7 days?
Trouble. Where do we go to find it? I've sent my guests and they've gone through searching. But to no avail. What do I do?
Igwe!
Igwe, may you live long.
Igwe! You're welcome.
Elders of our community!
You're welcome.
Your Highness, we have come for the oath taking. Glad that Ezemo is already here, so it makes it easier for everyone. So, shall we all proceed to the Ogugu shrine where the oath will be?
So, you people have not heard.
Heard what?
That the Ogugu head is missing.
It's true.
What?
It's true.
Ogugu head is missing.
Missing how?
What are you talking about?
Is it true?
It was stolen yesterday while I was at the bush gathering some herbs. Also, my forefathers. Why me?
What kind of money?
Don't bring in our forefathers into this matter. What? How can you be here and you are in charge of the Ogugu shrine? And you are telling us that it's gone missing. And you are standing here.
If that is play, don't play it with some of us.
Ezemo, what does that mean? You are in charge of Ogugu head and got missing. All right, Ezemo, what do we do now?
I don't know. The whole thing baffles me.
You knew what happened to our shrine. But we'll get back to that.
Igwe, what do we
look at that?
Can't we go to any other shrine, anywhere, to take this oath? That is what we are here for.
Yes, because it's very, very, very important. The accusation was too much. It's unbearable. So you people should choose any other shrine. Let's go there after we visit the situation at hand.
Well, as you did, and Chico, you're all right. But the oath taking should wait. I have more problems in my hand now than that oath taking. My people, what are we going to do about this Ogu head missing?
Igwe, we don't know.
Igwe, something important must be done before it will be late.
What are you people talking about? Look at him. Answer him.
Something
he has the answer to that.
Before it will be late.
Let us go.
Igwe, something important must be
done. When you people are ready, for good second, let us know.
Igwe,
what for me? He should answer. Provide that shrine.
Igwe, what is happening in this kingdom? Igwe.
Take this orange.
Orange? No, I can't take it from you. My father said that we should not take anything from you and in Seko. He said that you people are evil.
What am I hearing? Your father said so?
Yes.
Come. Come closer. Come. Don't be afraid, eh? Come. Tell your father that I, Mazu Dene, said tomorrow he will die. And on the day of his burial, there will be flood and rain.
I am the Abegimo. Leha, the Abegimo. Sapwa kananjo, yoja Abegima.
Let me out. I'm here to stop Udin and Siko from their evil deeds. Their Kanta is here. I'm here to stop them because I make and stop rain. Omudiela!
Hear me out. I'm here to stop Udin and Siko from the evil deed.
Their Kanta is here. You! Tell everybody that I, Ikeri, the greatest rainmaker, is here. I'm here to stop Udin and Siko. Go! Tell everybody! Omudiela! I repeat, I'm here to stop Udin and Siko from the evil deed. I'm here to stop them from killing the whole community. Omudiela! Omudiela!
See, Iked, if only you can do it, the whole village will rely on you, the whole village.
Okudu.
Mm-hmm.
Okudu.
Mm-hmm.
Just go and bury your father.
Mm-hmm.
Just go and bury your father. Eh? There will be sunshine all through.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Trust me.
Thank you.
Not for you, those evil men would have flooded my father's burial with rain.
Okude, don't worry. The end of the road is here.
Okay.
Eh? Okay. I, Ikedi, the greatest rainmaker in this village, in this community, is here for them. Let them come. I'm ready for them anyhow they want it, eh?
That is why I brought this gift, to say thank you.
You have done well, my brother. You have done well. You are welcome. When you are going, tell everybody, every human being in this village, okay, that I, Ikedi, the greatest rainmaker in this village, is ready for them.
Okay.
You can go.
Thank you. I will do just that. I have to leave now.
Okay.
this. For us not to have any problem between us,
Let us give you some money. So you can go back to your mother's village and let the sleeping dog lie.
Is that
Mazi.
Ikete.
Mazi then. I can't understand what you're driving at. Do you want me to go back so you can have enough space of caging the whole community?
That's where you always go wrong. Nobody is caging the community. Listen to us.
Ikete, we know you like your life. Let us help you live longer. There is joy in living long. We don't want to terminate your life. Snuff out life in you so that you can have longevity. Can't you understand?
You are not making any point.
Ikede, it is the fly that does not listen that follows the corpse to the grave.
I've heard you. Please, can I go now?
We will go too. Won't we go?
Why not?
We will go. We will go. But listen and listen very well. There are many ways to kill the rat.
Mazi, you are a nobody.
Look at you, boy. Oh, my son, you can't hear me. Did you hear that?
Mbuma the both of you are punch of the nobodies.
Mbuma Kwasala! Arab Nagu Mbume! Nsiko.
Did you hear that?
Hey! Hey! We shall see!
Odemma.
We shall see!
Odemma.
Hey, woman! Lily silicon only more. Oh, my silicon only more! Where's your brother? Where's the kid?
He's not around.
Come, you must warn him. You must warn him not to interfere in our business. We are not going to take it lightly with him again. If he interferes in our business, did you hear me?
Please, Innai, I'll talk to him when he comes back.
You better do. Because we are not going to be happy with him anymore. Can you imagine that little boy? Stopping us from making rain for an occasion that we were not paid for, thereby making us look stupid.
I've heard you.
Yes.
I'll talk to him, please.
Warn him. He is lucky that he's not here. I would have skinned him alive.
I've heard you, Nai. Please, I'll talk to him.
You don't talk to him more. Talk to him!
Ikede, come back here. Where are you going? Ikede!
Look, please. I don't want those men and their trouble. Why not accept that offer and let them be?
Accept the offer? Yes. Or let the money? And allow them to be threatening the whole community with rain?
You know those men are evil. That's why everybody in this village keep on avoiding them. Why are you looking for their trouble? Why?
I'm not looking for their trouble. They make and stop rain. I do likewise. So, why can't they let me be, Why can't they let me be?
I suggest you should go back to a maternal home.
Maternal? Because of those evil men? I'm not going anywhere, sorry. I'm not going anywhere. This is my father's land, Let them do their worst,
Ikede.
See, Ngozi. I think this discussion is over, I'm going somewhere, just stay.
Ikede!
Don't call my name again. Don't call my name again,
Quick.
The fly that does not hear. Now you are somebody, eh? And we are nobody. You are somebody. Somebody the great.
There is no point crying. Stop crying. When next you come to this world, you will learn how to respect noble men like us.
Bury him! give me that! Give me that!
Tell the god of rain that I,
All about quick, in them one ante, Igwe and the elders of our land. I call for this emergency meeting because of all the atrocities that have been happening in this land. Ogugu has found evil in the hands of Nseko and Udene here seated, and has asked for the banishment of both of them out of this village.
Yeah? Ezemo, why do you have to accuse us wrongly? Why accuse us wrongly? Which Ogugu spoke to you? Has Ogugu not been stolen? Look at this man.
Yeah, Nseko. Stop interrupting Ezemo. Stop interrupting him. He is trying to pass across the west of the gods.
After all, he is the mouthpiece of the gods.
Yes. Sit down and let reasonable people talk.
He is the mouthpiece
Ezemo, of the gods. That your plan to banish us from our fatherland, it cannot work.
Cannot.
It cannot work.
Udene and Nseko, you are definitely going to be banished from this land.
Yes.
As Ogugu has spoken.
Yes.
Igwe, that is impossible. Nobody, I repeat, none of you can send us out of this land. We belong, this is our land. This is our land. And none of you has the power. If you want, try, let us see.
Nseko and Udene, everyone else, yes, could be afraid of you, but I, Ezemo, I am not afraid of you. By tomorrow morning, I will personally lead the group that will throw you out of this village.
Alright. So, you feel you can challenge us? Don't run away. Let's try and see.
Let's go.
Out!
Let them go.
Let them go. Let them go. After all, bad water and good water cannot flow from the same source. Bad water and good water cannot flow from the same source.
Let them go.
Elders, I'm so happy that the gods has decided to intervene in the case of our land.
Nseko, Udene, what are you both doing here? By the way, how did you manage to come in here in the first place?
What kind of stupid question is that? When you already know the answer. Maybe I should ask you, does pot make noise without hands, you know, touching it?
I still don't understand. I don't understand. I don't know.
ogologunda udene na siko benye abuo amama ni mobodo ana maru madabo adinjo.
Must definitely leave this village. They thought they are strong, but when Zemo will finish with them, they will know they have jammed the rock.
I agree with you.
You are right. I say you are right. I can't imagine how two men, Umadebo, will hold the whole village hosted for so long.
I'm happy the girls have finally remembered them.
They must surely leave this community.
Enough here now.
Unbelievable.
Child.
Oko bo igwe akwa.
Ndi cheke the moon.
Igwe.
I invited you people here to tell you that it is quite unbelievable that Ezemo, who has the powers of Ogugu, could be terminated by this evil man. If that be the case, then we are no more safe.
Igwe, honestly, I am shifting my ground on this matter. I mean, it is said that when crocodiles eat their own eggs, then what would they not do to the flesh of a frog? On Dokano? Eh? Well, we ordinary people are not safe in this community. If Ezemo could be killed by this evil man, therefore, Igwe, I am suggesting that we allow Nseko and Udine to stay.
It seems you are afraid. You already afraid.
It's not as if I'm afraid.
No, you are afraid.
Okay, does it mean you don't have anything to contribute?
My brother Kalunta. Igwe, I'm sorry. Igwe, you know, okay. It's not that I'm afraid. They drive me that pull them out. I'm not afraid. But you know, I love my wife so much. I don't want her to become a widow overnight. You know, Nseko and Udene, they are deadly snakes. Nseko and Udele, they are deadly.
They are deadly snakes. Honestly.
Igwe. I, Ozo Osiri, I'm not afraid of Nseko and Udele. Who are they? Igwe, why can't we banish them from this community?
Banish?
Who are they?
Banish Udena and then Seko.
From this community. I'm not afraid of them.
Please, the day of the banishment, I will not come. Count me out. You know?
Hey, well, Arichi, at least I'm encouraged by your own courage. But meanwhile, we will let this problem lie low until after the burial of Ezemo, the chief priest. Then we will come back to it and then do justice.
Okay.
If you say so, there's no problem.
The wine is coming from Okala for the Dioch.
Yes.
That man is a good tapper. But that's why I've never thought of killing him. I don't want him to die so that...
whatever comes out of his palm, raffia.
Well,
who used to nourish our body.
Ah,
Sent you to eliminate us. Talk.
You don't want to talk, eh? Madness will strike the both of you as soon as you leave this compound.
Is. And he must die.
That person must surely die.
Can you imagine?
Hey!
Coming to eliminate the eliminators.
Anyway.
Your time is up in this village.
I don't understand what you mean.
You understand what we mean. You dare to gang up against us. You and your cabinet are planning to eliminate us.
It's impossible.
Gentlemen, what are you people insinuating? Why are you telling lies against us? Why?
Ujel and Oseko, how dare you? How dare you come here and talk to Igwe like that?
Who is this one? Who are you?
Igwe, shut up! Igwe, I'm going to sit down.
Sit down.
Don't talk when I'm talking.
Sugar and Udene,
I want you to leave this place now.
Otherwise,
now.
You
otherwise,
cannot ask us to leave this place.
What?
Because you are a nobody.
You are spineless.
You are a nobody.
Yes.
I cannot send you out of this place.
You dare not.
Okay.
Guys! Your Highness,
take these men out of this place. Now!
Alright. We shall go. Hey! We don't talk.
We shall go, but we will see. We will see. Let's go.
Udene.
What is the problem with this man? Continue terrorizing the village. The gods will catch up with you people.
Yes, Igwe.
I am getting more scared of this village. People keep dying every day mysteriously.
Komanna, this is terrible. This is terrible. Imagine Diwe, who sat with us yesterday in the meeting, to die this morning under a mysterious circumstance.
Ifukwa.
This must be the handiwork of evil people in this community.
You are right. You are right. I am suspecting. Mazi Udene. And
guard your mouth, my
friend. Call his friend. The truth must be said.
Stop talking nonsense. Don't you know this is an open place?
If you want to talk, you guide your tongue. Don't talk over anything you see.
Must you mention somebody's name?
If you know how to, you guide your mouth in most cases.
My friend, let's go.
And when we get to the palace, we can discuss this. My fellow elders, I am dumbfounded. I don't know what to say. Even in my widest imagination, I wouldn't believe such calamity could happen to our Igbo. This is a man that sat with us here the other day. All of a sudden, the next thing we are hearing is that he is dead. Just like that. I am saying it that minds are not clean in this village. Minds are not clean. It is said that all lizards lie prostrate. No one knows the one that suffers from bellyache. Who knows the next victim?
Counter, my friend. I'm afraid as well. Why, Igwe? Why, Igwe? How? Obakabana. Obakabana.
What has he done?
How?
A man of all people. Does he deserve to die? What has he done?
The Shibem. So, no, no, but
there's a big problem in this community.
Where came an answer? Now you know that there is problem in this community. No, no, no.
The other day,
when we were deliberating it,
calm down.
He stood his ground.
Calm down.
He said, Igwe, I am by your side. You know that there is problem now. You are the cause of all these things. If we should apportion any blame, it will go to you.
Calm down. What has come over you? What has come over you? The Igwe is not yet buried.
No.
And you have already taken his throne, Nseko.
See that. Well, maybe I should educate you, Ma. See, you people can go ahead and bury the Igwe. For your information, it is now the turn of my clan to produce a ruler that will govern this community. And I, being the oldest...
Nseko, who told you that you are the oldest?
Esiko, are you older than Mazo, dude?
Oh.
Eh? Mazi Kalonto.
Eh?
Now for Damn. Information. Mazi Idodo is close to his grave.
Mm-hmm.
He cannot save you. And let me warn you. Be mindful how you talk to me. Because I am now the well. I am your Adigwe now, right?
Even if Mazi Ododo is close to his grave, I mean, he has a son. Eh? If he dies today, his son takes over the throne traditionally. You are not supposed to be here. If we should follow tradition, you are supposed to be presented to the village before sitting on this seat.
Hey, hey. Be careful how you talk to Adigwe, lest you be banished from this land.
For what?
Huh?
Eh? Udene, you can't banish us, eh?
Eh? But if you people are not being careful, nemesis will catch all of you.
Exactly.
Eh? Wait yes. and see. Hmm? Wait and see.
Nemesis.
Sit down first.
You wait. You wait.
Yeah. What do we do with these people?
Hmm? No, no, we'll come closer. No, we'll come. Come. Look, Craig.
Una lala. Una lala.
This nonsense must stop. How can they take over the throne of the land without going through the traditional procedure? That will stop. I'll go there and make sure that they step down from that throne. What nonsense is this?
Nay, where are you going?
What nonsense?
Why don't you avoid you dinner and the sick of
what nonsense?
Yes, Papa, he's right. Those people are like life vipers.
I won't continue to allow them to intimidate our people. It will stop. Just watch what I'll
Papa,
do.
Papa, it's okay.
I'll
now.
Go there and make sure Nseko steps down from that throne.
Papa, I'm afraid.
Don't be afraid.
I'm afraid.
Don't fear for your father. Your father is a fearless lion. Just listen. Listen to what I will do. I'm going there straight. Those two bones in the neck of our people, I will destroy them. Just watch it.
Please don't go.
Oh, no.
Just watch it.
On that throne. Nobody. Eh? It will bring shame to this community. It has never been done anywhere before. The irony of it all is that he coronated himself. Have you ever seen such a thing before? So we are not in support.
It is true that my father Idodo, who is to take over the throne, is sick and old. But as the first son, it is my traditional right to take over my father's position.
Of course, Ekenna, you are right. In this case, I would have advised you to forget the throne. Nseko and Udele, they are dangerous.
Ichie, I am not a coward. It is only a coward who runs away when he is put to test. Listen, I must make sure that Nseko leaves that throne, no matter what it takes.
My son, first thing, you have to be very careful. Be very careful. Nsiko Abrokwana Agweji Apuka Mebu. He's not an easygoing man. Please be very careful when dealing with him.
Thank you very much, Ichie, for your advice. Listen, what the hen is chasing in the rain is very, very important to the hen.
Okay. Okay. She says so.
How many wives have you acquired since this regime?
Your Highness, I cannot count them.
Enjoying yourself, good morning. Not minding the old Igwe.
What? What?
You mean that this girl stole this cock that she's carrying?
Yes, Your Highness. She was caught at the very act.
Pundas shall never end.
Onyoriokuko, this is incredible. Your Highness.
Hello.
If this big girl can steal a cock, if she's let loose, she will steal a human being.
Exactly.
Your Highness, I think this girl should be killed to cleanse the land.
Oh, yes.
That is the tradition.
Please, Your Highness. I'm not a thief. I was only playing with a cock.
You are playing with a cock. Tell that to the birds.
Play.
Tell the birds that. By the way, where are your teammates? Huh? That you have to play with a cock. Do you know you are possessed?
Okay then, Your Highness. Take her away and execute her and bring her skull to me.
Please.
Consider it done, Your Highness.
Go! Get her skull to me! I will drink with the skull!
I don't know what this community is turning into. Listen, as long as Nseko is on the throne, the community will keep suffering. To what do I owe this visit?
The king wants to see you now.
I can't honor his invitation. As far as I'm concerned, we don't have any king. I am the rightful heir to that throne.
Will you shut up that your mouth before Amadeon permanently shut it for you?
Shut up for what? Eh? Shut up for what? Who coronated Nseko at the first place? He only got to that throne because he thinks he has power. But I'll prove him wrong. I'm going to prove him wrong! By the time I'm through with him, this community will be too hot for him.
Don't talk so about the king. Listen, Ekena. We are only sparing your life because the king has not permitted us to hurt you. Now, to the palace.
Tell your so-called king that I will see him at my own convenience.
Are you saying you are not going to the palace with us now?
Tell your king, as I have told you. As you can see, I'm very busy. Please excuse me.
My Baba.
Ekena.
If you ask me, I will say you should follow them to the palace.
What?
Like I said, it's good you follow them to the palace.
To say the king, the so-called king. Don't call him the king. It irritates me when you call a cheat a king. Listen, that throne belongs to me. And I must do anything within my power to get to that throne. No matter what it takes, I'll pay the price.
I know, but it's good though if you follow them. You know that man.
I said I'll do it at my own convenience.
Okay, if you insist.
You sent for me.
Yes, I did. Ekenna, I have heard so much about you. I have heard a lot about your rantings, Ekenna, and I ask you, what is your problem?
You ask a question you already know the answer. The throne you are sitting upon, comfortably, belongs to Itodo's family. It is true that my father is ill, but as the first son, I am destined to take over the throne, and not you.
Ekenna, so you have the guts to stand in my presence and be talking this rubbish? Maybe I should remind you that I am the king. And nobody, not even you, will try me. You do not dare me. Huh?
Anyone who takes what belongs to a child and hangs it up must surely bring it down when his hand becomes weak. And then the child will take what rightfully belongs to him.
So what are you insinuating?
The throne is mine. You have to step down.
Now listen to me, Ekenna. And listen good. My ears are wide open. Any day, any other day, that you will do anything detrimental to me or to my throne, that same day you will be hanged. You heard me. Now will you leave my presence? Get out!
First, king, you are alive. I know why I have been keeping quiet.
I know why I have been keeping quiet.
Of land does not belong to you anymore. From henceforth, it is now royal heritage. Did you hear that?
What?
Did I make myself clear?
Your Highness, please, don't do this to me. This is the only land my late husband's family left for my son and I. Please.
Shut!
Look, woman.
There
is no need begging His Royal Highness. He has decreed, and that is final.
Please.
Don't
sell my body.
Leave this place.
Please.
Don't ever